Hello and welcome back. This is Darius Torana, and we are back on Valheim Raveguard. So, we've been prepping up for the motor fight. We are all ready to go at this point. I've got stamina potions, healing potions. I've got my foods, which I'm going to go ahead and eat now. My bow, flint head arrows. I am going to put the cultivator away because I super don't need that. Now pull the crude bow off the wall. Put the cultivator here for now. That's weird. Three. There we go. And we'll put the bow in here. I've been farming up a lot and getting stuff all set up there. But yeah, beyond that, everything is just about ready to go. So we're going to go ahead and go and take on Motor. And yeah, all in all, we should be good to go. So I'll go ahead and come back in here. Rave should be waiting. It's not yet, but he should be ready soon. Made meats for the first time. That was pretty cool. But yeah, so I'll bring you guys back in once we're ready.
Back to where we normally sit.
Sure. And we are back. Alright, so we got our rested buff up. We are all set and ready to go. It looks like it might be getting dark out.
Well, as always, I did a thing. So,
okay.
What arrows are you using?
Right now I'm just using flint head.
Yeah. See, I think we need to up our game before we go fight a big dragon boss. So, since we've gone and done lots of running around through the plains that we technically shouldn't have done yet, have some needle arrows.
Alright, sweet.
Yeah. These are the best arrows that we're able to get right now.
Okay.
Although I still prefer the frost, but frost arrows don't work very well against the frost dragon.
Yeah, I figured they probably wouldn't. Do you think we should bring some frost resist potions, or is it not going to do anything because of our cloaks?
I don't think it helps because of the cloaks. Let me double check. Yeah, the frost resist potion only gives you resistance to frost, and our cloaks give you resistance to frost.
Okay. Alright, well, I think I am just about ready.
My armor also gives me resistance to frost.
Oh, that's cool.
I believe yours does too, actually. You're wearing the wolf armor. Yeah.
It protects against the cold. Yep.
Mm-hmm.
Nice.
Oh, I'm curious. What's your armor value up to now?
79.
Yeah, that's what I thought. You have to beat by 25.
Oh, jeez.
I'm at 44.
Wow. Alright. Yep. Let's see how dark it is outside. Yeah, it looks like it is getting
very dark. Yeah, so we should definitely go sleep.
Go sleep, and then we'll go take on Motor.
Yep. Which we never rename the portal, so it's still the one in the crafting hall. Okay.
Right.
Your house is so much closer than mine. Even with my faster running speed, you still beat me.
Let's see.
So, we gotta do our usual sweep for bad guys. Like that Drake who would be annoying to join in the fight. And then we've already got the dragon eggs there and everything, so we're good to go.
Yep.
Oh, that drake dropped me a trophy.
Oh, nice.
Ooh, my jumping skill made it back up to 26.
Yay!
I've had so much skill loss from dying so much lately. It used to be in the high 50s, low 60s.
Oh, jeez.
Yeah. My running skill used to be the same. It's probably terrible now, too.
My jumping skill just made it to 28.
Woo!
Let's see.
Alright, there's a wolf. I don't see any stone golems.
Yeah,
this
is
going to be a wonderful and terrible place to fight Motor.
Alright.
It's wonderful because there's lots of open line of sight. Terrible because there's little cover that doesn't involve falling off the hill.
Alright. Well, I am excited.
Yeah, it'll be fun. There is plenty of space to run, though. But we want to avoid being bunched up too much.
Okay. Normal dragon fighting tactics.
Pretty much. Would you like to come do the honors of summoning?
Oh, we got another drake over here.
Oh. Where'd you come from?
I missed. Wow, I cannot hit him.
Then.
All right. Here we go.
All right. Oh, did you remember your spear?
Yes.
Excellent. Yeah, it looks like she's gonna spawn up over here. Oh, she spawned in the air. Okay. All right, move it.
Again. Hit her.
Yeah, I think I only hit her once so far. Oh. On the ground, but I have no stamina. Okay. I'm gonna pop bow mask and start doing with the spear.
Oh my god, frosted.
Yep, she slowed me with the frost. Oh, ouch, that hurts more than normal. Staying on the ground for a while. Guys, we're getting some good damaging on her. It's also a great time to use your stamina potion to. Well, not anymore. But when she's on the ground like this, it's a great time to use your stamina potion to.
That's what I did.
Excellent. Alright, she's on you.
Wow. Okay.
Yeah, she tickles.
A little bit.
Shooting at me this time.
Oh yeah, I'm dead.
Oh.
Yeah, she one-shot me. I had over 100 health.
Yep, and you got better armor than me too. Okay, well I will keep her busy while you come back and get your stuff.
Sounds good.
When you see her shooting, just stop what you're doing and start running. Usually side to side works best.
Okay.
Oh, I think we have a drake coming in too. Yep.
Well,
okay, drake down.
Got my food re-upped and I got a frost resistance potion on, so I should be able to get to my stuff pretty easy.
Alright, don't forget to get your rested buff back.
Oh, I did forget to do that.
That's the terrible part of dying, because you just have to sit there and wait. Alright, she has landed, but I'm not. Oh, I still have my mask. Not get off in time. Watch your health. You do not have a mask. Wow. We're only like 3 or 4 minutes into this fight. Maybe 5 with her flying around before she landed the first time. We're doing good work. And there she goes. Alright, she's firing you.
Actually, it didn't even hit me.
Oh, good. It is like 400 damage to one of the rocks.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, but the rocks have no armor.
Oh, she hit me that time. Ow.
Yeah. The more of those things that she hits you with, the more damage it does, too. Alright, she's back on the ground. A few more seconds before I can use my stamina potion. Alright. Oh, I'm not tickled. You bit me.
Ah, dang it.
Come around and fire at you again. There she goes. Oh, she just destroyed that tree. She's back on the ground.
Odors and tears.
Nice. That was definitely the easiest time I've ever had doing this.
Nice. Ooh, we got an artisan table.
Yeah.
Ooh, and a motor trophy.
And just in time for the whiteout to completely block all my line of sight.
Nice. All right.
All right. Pick up a little bit of this wreckage laying on the ground, and it's time to head back and turn in the trophy. Hard to find what she broke.
Oh, the Draugr Elite Trophy gives you an Iron Sledge.
Yep. It's like an upgraded version of the Stag Hammer.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, so it does a little bit of an area effect damage around it.
Gotcha.
Pretty cool, actually. Well, I have to say that went extremely well.
Yeah, only one of us died once.
Yeah. It's probably a new record for me. Usually I die once.
All right. Did you get one of the motor tier things or the dragon tiers?
I got 8.
Oh, you got 8. Okay.
Yes.
I got 2.
Takes 2 every time that we make an artisan table from it.
Oh, okay.
One second, they'll be done putting stuff away, and then we can go to spawn.
Sounds
Looks
good.
Like you're already renamed the portal.
Yep.
Excellent. What was the name of the old portal? Oh, it was just unnamed, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Excellent. Okay. We should go back and rename it to Motor.
Yeah. Right. Let's see here. I'm assuming it's this one that looks like a dragon.
That seems like a good assumption.
Always tailwind when sailing. That seems very useful.
It is. It's very nice for sailing. And if you got a sea servant chasing you that you don't want to fight, just hit that and you can outrun the sea serpents in the longboat.
Oh, nice.
Okay, I'm gonna hold on to Bowmaster right now.
Okay.
Alright. Yeah, ready to go straight off to the Ogloff fight?
I mean, we can definitely do that, I guess. Do we have what we need?
I wouldn't recommend it, but...
Oh, okay. What do we need for that one?
You're probably going to want to upgrade your armor and shield.
Okay.
And I want to upgrade my shield and my pickaxe and axe because I can.
Sounds good. What does an artisan table give us?
Oh. Well. You know how I've been saying that we can't do anything with the black metal?
Yeah.
And how the blacksmithing area, or the foundry area, has smelters down one side and the other side is empty?
Yeah.
The artisan table allows us to make blast furnaces.
Oh,
okay. So that we can... do the advanced metal types.
Gotcha.
So that's why I specifically made room for the blast furnaces over here.
Gotcha.
On top of that, it also allows us to make windmills so that we can grind the barley grains into flour so that we can cook stuff with it.
Okay.
And it allows us to make a spinning wheel so that we can turn flax into thread and start making flaxen clothes and equipment.
Nice.
And then it also allows us to make one more thing, is there? Maybe? I want to say there's one more thing, but I'm not sure what. Oh yes, the oven. It allows us to make the stone oven so that we can cook pies and stuff.
Oh, okay.
All of which requires iron.
Ah, excellent.
Yes. So, back to the swamps for us.
Gross.
Some of it just needs to be iron nails for the windmill and the spinning wheel, which we could make iron at Overlook Sanctuary into iron nails and then bring that home.
Okay.
To the teleporter. But that's just the windmill and the spinning wheel.
Yeah,
the stuff that we actually need here, the stone ubbing and the blast furnaces, are straight iron.
Dang.
Yeah. So we're going to want like 4 or 5 stacks of iron probably.
Okay. Well, I guess that is going to be a good wrap for this episode.
Yeah.
So yeah, thank you guys so much for joining us today. If you did enjoy the episode, slap a like, comment, subscribe, and until next time, keep on surviving.
And have fun gaming. Goodbye.